Welcome to Empowered Through Health with Dianne Solano, bringing you interviews with health and wellness experts from around the globe, educating, entertaining, and inspiring. Empowered Through Health starts now.
Hello, everyone. Dianne Solano here, meeting all of you for the first time, multiple times, I'm not sure, but what I do know, health is one of the most important foundations for your life if you really want to live a life full of purpose, energy, and complete focus. My name is Dianne Solano. I'm an orthomolecular nutritionist and your podcast host for today. And, you know, every Tuesday now, what we're doing is we are uploading our show notes. You can get that on Transformation Talk Radio or on your favorite podcast app, whether that's through Apple, whether that's through Spotify, whether that's on Google. You can definitely find many of our shows that have now been recorded. We feature many, many health professionals around the world that are doing epic work in the field of health and wellness, using your own body's innate potential to rebalance, to restore, and ultimately use that frequency of that intelligence of our 100 trillion cells that we've had and carried on this earth for thousands of years. So the goal of this show and the mission of the show is to empower you with tools, strategies to unlock your own body's innate healing of potential. Disclaimer, it's all about information. It's just about empowerment. It's really about letting Mother Nature take its course. This show is not here to diagnose. It's not here to give you any sort of medical advice. Rather, just open up your world to a new possibility, to new avenues, new strategies under many, many different health topics. Here's what I know. The body is so amazing at healing, at getting better, if you just give it the right tools and foundations. We have thrived on health and wellness, nutrition, food, electromagnetic frequency, many wonderful topics in which our bodies have been able to thrive for thousands of years. And somehow, a lot of us have forgotten that. So again, every week, we're here to empower you, the listener, to take your life, your family's life, your friends, everyone that you love to the next level. Because without health, you don't have anything. So for today's show, I'm going to actually be the one giving you the conversation. I'm going to talk about polycystic ovarian syndrome, also known as PCOS. Now, some of you may have heard of this term before, some of you may have not. All I know was I personally was challenged with polycystic ovarian syndrome. See, that's the reason why I actually got into this field of health and wellness. And I'm gonna rewind a little bit about my story and my journey with this hormonal imbalance that's actually running the lives of many, many women. They not even may be aware of it, but let me tell you, polycystic ovarian syndrome is definitely something that's on the rise. In the standard medical community, it's very, very often undiagnosed. They'll tell you, for the most part, that they don't have a solution. There's no real, you know, cause and effect. It's just something that happens. It's genetic. But I'm here to tell you it's more lifestyle. So what we want to do in this show is, again, empower you and give you tools. This may be relatable. This may not be relatable. But what have you got to lose except learn a little bit more and empower yourselves and the people around you? So let me kick it off with my story. Let's rewind. I must have been probably about 15, 16 years old. I was hitting that area of puberty. Many of us can probably recall those times. Many women develop a lot earlier than their years, some a little later. I was falling kind of in that in-between stage, 13 years, starting to see, you know, the breast development, the things changing, the curves coming along, and that's all great. But I never got a full cycle. I never got a full period. And I remember thinking, okay, this is really odd, but like they say, sometimes it takes a while. 14 years, birthday came along, nothing. 15th birthday came along, nothing. And I decided to pay the doctor a visit. And the doctor at the time looked at me and said, you know what, let's just put you on birth control pills, the standard protocol for imbalance of hormones. Well, at that age, what did I know? I didn't know any better. You just do what the medical community tells you. And again, you got to take this with a grain of salt. Every case is an individual case. And in my case, I didn't have an adult advocating for me, much less know much information myself. So I just decided to obey what the medical community told me to do. I went on birth control pills, stayed on it for a year, got off as planned, never got a cycle. That's when I went back to the doctor and I was just like, look, nothing's happening. What do I do? And that's when the doctor said, you know what, Dianne, you should just stay on them. Like, let's just face it, you know, we want to balance out those hormones. You're growing up. Life is going to push you forward to start dating. Why don't you just stay on the birth control pill? That's probably the best thing. And I thought, okay, that's exactly what I'm going to do. I stayed on birth control pills for the following 10 years. And it wasn't until I was in my mid-20s when I started to question the medical model. I started to question things because things just weren't adding up. I started to see friends and family go through chronic illness. At that time, I was studying veterinary medicine. I was learning a lot about the sciences around the world. And I just remember thinking, you know, now that I know a little bit more tools, I have questions. And when I started to ask these questions as to why, from a cellular level, I didn't get any answers. And that's when I knew something wasn't right. And I wasn't sure what that was. I just knew that just wasn't adding up. And that's what I want to share with all you listeners today. You are going to be your own best health advocate. When your gut tells you something isn't right, something's off, ask more questions. You got to do that. You're going to be the best advocate for your health ever. Doesn't matter who comes along, best surgeon, best expert, best nutritionist, best holistic practitioner, best functional medicine, many, many tests. You got to listen to that inner guidance. And that's exactly what happened. I decided, you know what, let's just get off these birth control pills and just give my body a chance to do what it's got to do. Sure enough, I got off, no cycle. Not only did I not get a cycle, I started losing my hair. I started breaking out into acne. I started losing weight, which is rare, by the way. Typically with polycystic ovarian syndrome, you start to see weight gain. In my case, I was just, you know, that rare 5% where I just started losing the weight. And I knew something wasn't right. Not sure what it was. And at that point, that's when I decided I needed to start seeking more help and more answers. And that's exactly what I did. I went to see the best gynecologist in South America. He saw me and he said, you know what, Dianne? You've got something called polycystic ovarian syndrome. It's typical. It's a genetic thing. Nothing we can do. Solution, stay on birth control pills. When you want to get pregnant, you may or may not be able to have kids. We don't know. But luckily now there's drugs for that. And we're just going to give you that medication when the time comes. And let's just see where it goes. Well, I decided to go ahead and follow the advice. But then again, that instinct in mind kept nudging. And I thought, you know what, let me get a second opinion. So I waited a year for the best gynecologist in Canada, Mount Sinai Hospital to be exact. And I remember just waiting out for a year. Finally, my appointment came around. I walked into the office. Top expert saw me, examined me, came back and said the exact same thing. Dianne, you've got polycystic ovarian syndrome. There's nothing we can do. It's a genetic thing. If you ever want to get pregnant, you know, let me know. We'll figure that out when the time comes. In the meantime, your best bet is to stay on birth control pills for the rest of your life. And I don't know about you, ladies and gentlemen, but I have to tell you, something in my gut didn't feel right. And I remember walking out of that hospital. I remember thinking, you know, that inner voice, there's got to be another reason. There's got to be a solution. And I decided at that moment to open up my doors to natural medicine. And that's why I'm here today. It was because of that particular moment in time, thinking, what have I got to lose? See, if you just do a little more soul searching, go a little deeper, ask more questions, you're going to be surprised energetically what's going to come your way, because you are asking those divine questions. Your frequency is now in the search of. And I'm telling you, if you ask people, take the advice from people that have been down the same road, you're going to be surprised what you come across. And that's exactly what happened. I started to look into natural strategies. I started to ask people that were seeing natural practitioners. I did see a couple of few people here and there at the beginning. Didn't feel right. I was just kind of still asking around until finally I met my first mentor. I met him through a friend of mine who was getting wonderful results in losing weight. This beautiful friend of mine, she couldn't lose weight for the life of her. And finally she found a natural practitioner who gave her some great natural advice, diets, food, supplement, lifestyle. And I thought, oh my God, I'd love to see this individual. Well, sure enough, when I had a chance to meet up with him, he started answering questions that I wanted to know on a deeper level, biochemically, why this and why that. And I started to get answers and I started to get excited. And I really wanted to commit to getting better. I wanted my life back. I wanted my hormones back. And he said, Dianne, here's what I need you to do for 1 week. And if you're a listener on this call, I challenge you to do the same exercise that I did 25 years ago. Get a pen and paper and write everything that you put in your mouth down. You're going to be surprised on what you see. that you are consuming. And don't change a thing. Don't judge it. Don't do anything different. Just write it down. Accountability is honestly your best friend. It's going to give you some honest feedback on your habits, on your perceived way of eating. It's a truth teller. And when I did that, I wrote every single little thing that crossed my lips. It went in my mouth. I wrote it down. If it was a little candy, I wrote it down. If it was a sip of pop, I wrote it down. If it was a bottle of water, I wrote it down. Nothing went on without it being written down. 7 days later, I show that practitioner at that time, my first mentor, I show him my list and he looked at it and he's like, Dianne, sugar, sugar, carb, sugar. You don't have what it takes to make hormones. And that's when I realized, oh my gosh, what do you mean? And he said, you don't have essential fats. You don't have proteins. You can't make hormones. Your body doesn't have the building blocks. And he said, look, if you want to build a house, you need specific materials to build that house. You need brick. You need wood. You need mortar. You need nails. Same thing with the body. The body needs specific nutrients to have biochemical processes that it's supposed to do. But if it's not getting it, it can't make it. And that's when I stood there and I'm like, I can't believe after years of seeing the best around the world, no one ever asked me what I ate. No one ever concluded or even thought that maybe I just didn't have the right building blocks because I wasn't having the right diet. And that's when I learned, oh, there's a huge relationship with what you eat and how you feel and how your body functions. And I was blown away. The lights were turned on. It was like I was in darkness all this time. And I couldn't believe the politics. I couldn't believe the lack of information. I couldn't believe the lack of studying and insights that a lot of the regular medical community, they don't study nutrition, not to the degree that it should be studied. I mean, you got to get to root cause. So this is where you are your own best health advocate if right now you're struggling. And I really want to get clear that the medical community is needed. It's important. There is an emergency, pants down, take me to the hospital. You know, you get hit by a car, you have something really anaphylactic shock. I mean, that is why it's there. But when you're looking at long-term chronic illness, I'm going to pull out a statement that I get from one of my coaches, mentors, and business partners, Sachin Patel, you know, skills over pills. It's not about symptom suppression. It's about getting to the root cause. What does your body need and what is it lacking? So let's go back to polycystic ovarian syndrome because that's what today's conversation is about. And I know this because I lived it. I didn't realize that I ate so much sugar that I actually increased my insulin level, which in some women can push and shunt expression of the androgen pathway. What does that mean? That means if you're eating so much sugar, carbohydrates, processed foods, you raise something in your body called insulin. That's what happens. That's what gets released when there's too much blood sugar pumping through your veins. And then what happens in some women is it triggers the response of the male hormones to express. This in some women can add to the increase in the size of their cysts in their ovaries because of this masculine gene expression. This is when you have too much testosterone. This is when that imbalance starts to happen. And when you start raising the male hormone, that's where you get the weight gain or the weight loss in my case. That's where you get the increased acne. That's where you get the hair loss is because women are now expressing too much male hormone based on the sugar and the processed foods that they're eating. Who knew that my poor choices over time compounded where it started to affect my hormone cycle. And that's when I learned that the best thing I could do was to get a grip on that diet and those poor food choices. What did I do? I got rid of the sugar addiction. And let me tell you, sugar addiction is real. They have done study on rats and they show that rats put in a maze where they can go for sugar anytime they want. You know, there's a group of rats put in a maze, put in a box, and they have access to sugar and they can just go and click on the sugar and get as much fill as they want. Then they took a group of rats and they compared them to cocaine. And the rats, there was group B in a box with cocaine. And they said, okay, let's see which substance is more addictive. It was the rats that had access to the sugar. Can you believe that? Sugar is more addictive than cocaine. And if you think about it, it is there for everyone at every age, at every stage. And this is where we really need to get a grip on these foods that we're choosing without knowing. sugar really does increase a lot of these endorphin highs in your brain. It's a brain substance. It's a brain high. So you're constantly going after it. You look for it more and more and more. So the one thing I learned I had to do was to get it off completely. But I was committed. When you want change, you do what it takes. You either suffer the pain of the discipline or you suffer the pain of the regret and keep living with the pain and the imbalance that you're going through. And I knew I wanted a new life. I wanted my body back. And so I committed and I went home and I got rid of all the jams and all the juices and all the breads. And I sat there and I just started following the diet plan. In this case, we're looking at whole foods. We're looking at high fiber. We're looking at protein. We're looking at healthy fats. We're getting rid of all the whites, the white bread, the white starches, the white rices, the potatoes. And oh my gosh, the mental clarity, the beautiful skin, the thicker hair, it all started to come back because my body got the building blocks that it needed to move forward powerfully. And that's what my conversation on this topic is. Polycystic ovarian syndrome is real. And the root cause is not a genetic predisposition. It is 95% of the time an insulin-induced challenge. So how do you test for polycystic ovarian syndrome? Well, if you're lucky, there are some things you can ask the doctor to give you. Typically, it's not very common, but depending what part of the world you're in and how connected you are, you can always ask for, you know, blood sugar, insulin sensitivity tests. Now, I don't think they're super accurate. I think the best way to measure how sensitive your blood sugar is, and I urge every adult to do this because you're going to be surprised. You won't know if your blood sugar is stable or not. It's just such a silent process in your body, and it's not until things go really, really wrong over the years. But you can catch things well in advance if you use a glucose monitor. You can literally have one strapped to your arm. Now there's new technology. You don't have to prick your finger anymore. Back in the olden days, that's how I did it. But you really want to get a sense of how blood sugar sensitive are you. And it's amazing when you can test yourself with someone else in your household. Because if I have a piece of watermelon, my blood sugar spikes to 13 here in Canada, which is very, very high. Yet when my ex-partner had a piece of watermelon, his blood sugar probably went to 7. And this is when you realize we're also biochemically unique. So even though there's a glycemic index of foods, you're going to be surprised on certain foods that affect you differently than your sister or your neighbor or your partner or your spouse or your child. So you will only know how sensitive you are based on you. And that's where I encourage you, if you need to get a finger prick test or you can actually hook yourself up to one of those glucose measuring machines that you can put on your body and just walk around, chart your food intake. See what you like and what your body doesn't like. And now you're in the complete driver's seat of your health. And the truth is, when you maintain insulin levels low and you can really manage that stress, a lot of chronic illnesses come from inflammatory processes, which is chronic stress and insulin. So how does this work with diet with polycystic ovarian syndrome? Well, this is where you want to test the blood sugar if you can. And if you go personal, that is your best way. You can do an ultrasound. A lot of docs may or may not do it. And not all women show cysts right away. So it is possible to have polycystic ovarian syndrome without the real cysts showing up yet, but you're in those stages of it potentially happening. The bottom line is if there's too much androgen, meaning too much male hormone expression, and you don't have, and you have the insulin resistance, that's when you have the irregular cycles. So that is where the issue lies. Now, there are going to be a handful of women that aren't that traditional. They're non-insulin resistant, yet they have high testosterone. They're still having, you know, imbalanced hormonal cycles. And that's where you want to turn around going, okay, you know, is there something else going on? Is the body not producing enough estrogen? How old is this individual? You know, maybe we got to look at the pituitary gland and see, is that working effectively? So you do have to ask more questions and go down the rabbit hole. Some recommendations. I love Lorna R. Vanderhey. She's like one of my favorite kind of broad spectrum, general hormone balance, good information for women. That's really clear and easy to understand out there. She has a whole product line, both in the US and Canada. There's an oldie book, but goodie book that I really love. It's called Sexy Hormones. And there's some great quizzes in here now. And if you go to her website directly, you can definitely do a quiz there and find some extra information on all things hormones. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean, the hormone conversation is real. It is real. But when it comes back to polycystic ovarian syndrome, let's talk about food. Okay, so these are quick, easy strategies. Food is going to be something that you're going to want to nourish your body with. We're looking at high fiber. We're looking at low sugar, low insulin, and preferably no sugar. That's what I recommend. We really want to focus on good quality protein. And I love now walking into the supplement side of things, omega-3s. Omega-3s to me, high quality ones are the bomb. They're amazing at being able to balance out your hormones, your brain chemistry, all that. I mean, there's a reason why they call it an essential oil is because your body can't make it from any other source. So we want to be able to have those omega-3s coming in. I also really love medicinal mushrooms. For me, medicinal mushrooms have held so much weight in the recent years. You'll hear me talk about medicinal mushrooms on many different platforms because it's nature's intelligence. And over time, being a nutritionist, being a person advocate for health and wellness, I started to learn the power of Mother Nature. There's so much evidence now showing how Mother Nature is really, really supporting body chemistry more than it has ever. You know, your heart coherence, your quality of sleep, your relationship to the sun and the moon, and your ability to sleep properly, getting away from blue light. These are all strategies that are really going to help you with that hormone balance. And these are basics, guys. I know we talk about it, but we don't really fully understand how powerful, when you start changing all these areas of your body, how much your body bounces back. So when it comes to polycystic ovarian syndrome, you really want to be able to just go after it and not after it for a week. This is going to be a lifestyle change. It is going to be a lifestyle that you need to start adapting to. And usually food choices is step one. Step two is managing stress, working out a sleep cycle, working with the power of melatonin and serotonin. That's why going to bed at a specific time and waking up in the morning, doing some sun gazing, allows your body chemistry to start signaling. And if you can put it on a little bit of a regime, you're going to start giving it what it needs. Kind of like when you have a baby, you know, you need to give it a regime. Children love a regime. The body does very well when you give it that. So do your best at being able to do those kinds of natural strategies. Movement is a very big one as well. We're not moving now, and they're saying sitting is the new smoking. So if you're sitting down and you're not moving your body, have a timer to get up and move that body every hour, every 2 hours, because you're going to be amazed at how much it's going to flush toxins. It's going to bring back that circulation. Our bodies were designed to move, and it's only in the past 50 years we've just not really doing much anymore. We're on our iPhones, we're on our iPads. We're not really walking anymore. So this is where bodies are just going, whoa, what's going on here? Really, really powerful stuff. Another strategy really important for your hormone health and your hormone wellness is your ability to move your bowels. Yes, bowel function, there is a direct relationship with hormone signaling and bowel function. We got to make sure you're moving their bowels because all that metabolizes really powerfully along your liver receptor sites and then goes down the colon. That's how you clear out old recycled estrogen levels. And again, there could be estrogen toxicity and high androgen. That is totally normal. I'm not going to get too crazy about that. Conversation today is about PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. You may know that you have it. You may not know that you don't have it. Some of the symptoms may sound familiar, but the conversation today is to go after it. It really is a lifestyle issue. So you have to go after it. You have to do what it takes to get that under control. So let's recap. Go on a food cleanse. Go on a whole food diet. Fall in a way that's just a loving space for you. That's what you need to do when it comes to polycystic ovarian syndrome. Get rid of all things sugar, all things carbohydrates, starchy carbs specifically, and bring in that fiber, bring in that protein, bring in those essential fats. Get on a program, some wonderful herbs out there to support your hormone cycle. Get on a sleep cycle. Get moving that body. That is the best way for you to start turning this around. And it will take some time. It's not going to be a week thing. It may not even be a month thing. But these are the little areas you can start to improve on that's going to take you long-term over life. And don't you want a healthier, stronger body to be able to be the best version of you? Because that's what it's going to be all about. So if you want more information, if you ever want to try one of our 7-day, you know, health hacks, because we do small health hacks all the time. My goal for people is for them to be able to have access to information, make small changes that are really going to profoundly take them long term. And everyone now knows that they want quick, easy strategies that are effective, that don't cost a lot of money, but are really about a lifestyle, things you have access to already. It's just a matter of making it priority. Because if you make it a priority, that's when you start to change your life. So I'm going to leave you with those thoughts. Feel free to follow this podcast. We have so many topics, so many experts, more things coming down the pipeline. Today is about polycystic ovarian syndrome. If you want to jump on our free 7-day challenges, we have all kinds. We have a coffee challenge. We have a weight loss challenge. 7 days to start changing your life. Get an appetizer. Get a taste of what it's like to feel amazing. You can follow me at DianneSolano.com. Soon to be coming on our new app, which we'll be sharing more information on that. One-stop shop with the world's greatest speakers here on the Cornelia Stephanie Show. Have a wonderful, wonderful week. We look forward in sharing with you over the next few weeks on our new speakers and podcasts about to come out, all about empowered through health. Without health, honestly, you don't have anything. Let's make it a powerful one, apply those strategies, and we'll see you on the next podcast here at Transformation Talk Radio.
Thank you for listening to Empowered Through Health with Dianne Solano. For more information, visit senergy.ca. That's senargy.ca.